The breaking news story about Angelina Jolie's preventative mastectomies is another opportunity for us to continue to talk about increasing awareness about breast and ovarian cancer. I want to first of all congratulate Ms. Jolie for having the courage to write the op-ed that she did that appeared in the New York Times. Her story is really a very important one. Her mother had developed ovarian cancer at a young age, and fortunately, somewhere along the way, either her mother or Ms. Jolie herself was gene tested for the BRCA1 and BRCA2 genes. Ms. Jolie was found to be BRCA1 gene positive, which meant that she had about an 87% chance of developing breast cancer during her lifetime and approximately a 50% chance of developing ovarian cancer. By undergoing a preventative mastectomy, Ms. Jolie has lowered her chances of dying from breast cancer down to underneath 5%. Now, even with preventative mastectomies, it's important to remember that no breast surgeon can remove 1,000% of all microscopic breast tissue, and therefore the risk has been lowered by 95% that she'll ever die of breast cancer, and this is an important preventative step. One of the things that people ask me about all the time is, gee, Dr. Harness, are reconstructive techniques for breast cancer a lot better now? And the answer is yes. In reading the story of Angelina Jolie, she did undergo a nipple-sparing mastectomy. They utilized a technique called nipple delay, which meant that she had a little extra operation early on to free up the breast tissue from the underside of the nipple and a realer area, and to then delay the subsequent removal of the breast in order to maximize increasing the blood flow to the nipple areola area itself. Her second stage operation then was the removal of the breast tissue and with the placement of tissue expanders. And then several weeks down the road, she's had permanent implants put in place. The cosmetic results from this technique can really be excellent. And certainly not all patients need to undergo a nipple delay procedure. My own personal series is one of approximately 240 of these procedures, and the chance of losing the blood supply permanently to the nipple areola area is well under 5%. One of the questions that comes up is, do insurance companies cover the cost of these kind of preventative mastectomies? And really importantly, does the insurance cover the reconstructive process? And the answer to both these questions is yes. And when you think about it, from a selfish perspective of the insurance companies, preventing breast cancer up front is a lot less costly than a patient undergoing a preventative mastectomy, even if you include the costs of the reconstruction. Now, one of the questions asked is often, are there alternatives to preventative mastectomy? And the answer to that is yes. It's called very, very careful surveillance, done generally with digital mammograms and breast MRI. And again, when you're known to be gene positive, the cost of both of these screening techniques is fully covered by insurance. Again, I want to congratulate Ms. Jolie for her courage to write her op-ed. Women who have a history of ovarian cancer in their family should certainly be going and seeking the services of a gene counselor and possibly be tested for BRCA1 and 2. The same thing is true if there's a history of male breast cancer in the family, or there are multiple what we call first-degree relatives, mother, aunts, who had breast cancer particularly at a young age. So once again, we have a real teaching moment here. We are increasing awareness by the Angelina Jolie story. If there are any further issues or questions, please contact us at breastcanceranswers.com. Hopefully you find this information helpful to you in understanding this very, very important breaking news story. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.